Hello friends, I had a really great conversation with Arpita ma'am on English Diary platform. But don't get confused, this is not an Alina Ray's roast. We both are huge fans of her. But nowadays, I think rather than English content, she has been diverted to general conversations. I personally get bored watching them. But anyways, let's come and watch this conversation and learn many new things.
Okay, that's nice. So what are the channels you mostly follow for learning? That's unique because whenever I get any kind of learner, they say that they follow Alina Reis. That is the first one. Or they say, I watch conversation videos. So you are the one who says something, hey, that's nice. So why do you want to learn those kind of accents? What interest? So like, how long you have been learning spoken English? Practicing, and that what is the importance of English nowadays? What would you say? If I may ask you that while learning English, did you face any kind of challenges or all? Still, and you would learn another foreign language. I think you should choose
French. Normally, like, apni kemon achen? I'm interested in classical dance, Kathak.
Okay. I know you too. Very nice. So Arundhati, so you're from Chhattisgarh, right?
Yeah.
So should I introduce myself? I think already you know about me.
Yeah, I know a lot about you.
Wow, that's nice. There are a lot of books. Are you a bookworm?
Yes, I am.
Wow. In class 7 only you're a book one. When I was in class 7, I think I was okay in study, but not a bookworm. And now also I'm not a bookworm. I read books just for time pass.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah. As you mentioned that you like dancing. So what kind of dance form you do?
I'm interested in classical dance, Kathak.
Okay, Kathak. I also used to like learn Kathak when I was in class 5. So I know some of the basic, but I forgot.
I'm also like into contemporary dance.
Okay, contemporary. So have you watched Dance India Dance?
I used to watch it, but now I don't.
Yeah, I think now it's not there. It's like some other kind of Dance Plus. Yeah. I think those are there.
Yeah.
So like, how long you have been learning spoken English? Practicing, I mean to say.
I guess 2 years, maybe. In this quarantine, I have learned a lot about English. Like earlier, I was not so good in English. I knew English, but I was not so good. But in this quarantine, I started spoken English. I started learning vocabulary. I also learned a little bit of accent. And so maybe in this quarantine, 2020 and 2021, I learned a lot.
Okay, that's nice. Instead of wasting time, you practiced English. That is very good.
Yeah.
So you said that you are practicing some kind of accent. Which accent?
Yeah. I'm practicing a little bit of American accent. And I know a little bit of British accent as well. And I'm learning Spanish. I'm learning a little bit of Spanish as well. So I kind of sometimes... seldom get the Spanish accent sometimes.
Okay, that's nice. So why do you want to learn those kind of accents? What interests you?
It's like a skill, like something. Instead of wasting my time, I just wanted to learn something new, something unique. That most of the people want to learn languages, but I am learning accent. It's just a skill. I don't know why I'm learning it, but just for a skill and a hobby.
Okay, that's very good. So like how you're learning, through YouTube or your parents are also helping?
I'm learning through YouTube only.
Okay, that's nice. So what are the channels you mostly follow for learning English?
So there is this channel called Sounds American. It teaches all the American accent and everything. So I'm following that channel. Then I'm also following this American YouTuber called Dorman. He makes some inspirational stories and videos, and I follow them.
Okay, that's nice. And what about Indian channels? Which channels do you follow?
No, I don't actually. I don't watch much YouTube.
Okay, that's unique because whenever I get any kind of learner, they say that they follow Alina Reis. That is the first one. Or they say I watch conversation videos. So you are the one who says something different. You follow.
I also know about Alina Reis, but I don't follow her much. I sometimes watch her videos.
Yes, do you like her? I like her kinda, but it's not like that. People say that they're learning English, they're getting motivated, and I find that her channel is a little bit overrated.
Yeah, I also feel that.
Her channel is as if it's for fun, like whatever she say on her channel, it's like normal things which normal people can also say, that you and I also can say. But still, she has got like near 1 million subscribers.
Yeah, she like gives some tips which are like not that much useful. Instead of watching her, people can watch movies from there, they'll learn a lot.
Yes, like the recent video about unemployment she posted, like there were so many comments, like without even watching her video, like she posted instantly and she got so many comments, like we were waiting for the video, like whatever she said about unemployment, like though I don't know about much about employment and all, but still I can say that you don't should not give up. So whatever she said, what is special?
Like it's just a normal talk.
Exactly. And also, she said that her channel is all about English and all, but I searched some of the videos, like she posted some kind of vlogs also.
Yeah, vlogs, and sometimes she posted like earlier commerce related something, I guess.
Yes, yes. I think shake.com, those kind of site. Yeah, she's overrated. Other channels are very good, but I don't know. Maybe others can get offended if they hear our conversation.
Yeah.
Okay. So today's topic is all about, have you gone through the session document?
A little bit.
Okay. So it's all about importance of English. Okay. So if I may ask you, Arundhati, that what is the importance of English nowadays? What would you say?
So importance of English. English is like a skill and we all should know it because it's a global language and we can communicate really very easily if we know English. Many people don't know Hindi or the language you speak. Many people don't know that. But if you know English, so the possibility is there that the other person will also know English. So you can communicate really very easily. Like in India, in the southern part of India, people don't know Hindi, they mostly speak English. So you can communicate really very easily if you know English. And if you're talking with someone who is outside from India, like in some foreign countries, so you can also communicate with them if you know English. And it also gives an impression, like English has become a status.
Yes.
Like if you know English, you are on a higher status, but if you don't, you're on a lower status. This is like a stereotype that people have made.
Yes,
so that's a thing. I think everyone should know English because it's a really nice skill. And during in this era, people should know English.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, as you said that people judges like lower skill, like upper skill. Why is it so? What do you think? Why people have this kind of mentality?
Because if you know, because there's a mentality that if you know English, you must have studied in an English medium school, in a private school or expensive school. So that makes a expensive status, maybe, because that shows that you have a lot of money. But if you don't know English, it means that it is a stereotype, it's not true. It means that you have studied in a Hindi medium school, which is a little like less costly. So that means that you are poor. So that's a thing that's very wrong. And when you speak English, it also increases your confidence. So it's like, when you speak English, it automatically increases your confidence because English has that vibe which makes you feel more expensive type. So that's the thing. Maybe because of that.
Yes, and you know, people, I have heard mostly people saying that, ma'am, you're from which school? You studied from which school? I said English medium. So they were like, oh, ma'am, you're from English medium school. That's the reason you can speak. But it's not the fact, you know, I have seen that my friends also studied from the same school, but still they're not so fluent. So it's not like that. And on the other hand, I have seen that many people who have studied from Bengali medium school or Hindi medium, but still they're fluent.
Yeah. And you know what, there is one more advantage that if you know English, there will be more probabilities of getting good careers in a company or anything.
Mm-hmm. 40 to 50% of salary increases due to this.
Yeah, because you and get also, good jobs. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, and also communication skill is very much important. I have seen many people like they are fluent, but still they are not able to communicate. It's also another reason.
Right.
Yes, so if I may ask you, so as I can see, you're already good in English. I have seen quite like couple of your videos. You are good in that. So still, what are the areas you want to improve?
I want to improve my vocabulary because I want to learn new words. And if you know more words, your English will sound more fancy and everything. So I want to know those words and use them in my daily life. Yeah, vocabulary is a thing that I want to improve. And I also want to learn idioms and phrases because that makes your English look really clear and nice.
Okay, that's nice. So I would surely make a video about another video about idioms. Yeah. So, here I can see a question. Okay, so if I may ask you that while learning English, did you face any kind of challenges or all?
While learning English, I guess that I didn't have the environment. So it was a little difficult for me. I didn't have an environment except for my schools. And in school also, my friends used to talk in Hindi. So it was a little difficult to learn English, but I tried to learn English by watching some YouTube videos. So that was a thing that helped me overcome the challenges. And you know, in southern part of India, many people speak English. So if you want to learn English, it will be more easier if you stay there. So that's an advantage. But in my state, no one speaks English. So it was a challenge.
Yeah, for me as well. Because you know, people say that, ma'am, you're from English medium school. That is not the reason. You know, like my all friends, they speak in Bengali as it's my mother tongue, and some of my friends speak in Hindi. And also at my home, everyone speaks in Bengali, of course. And also I'm from Kolkata, so everyone Bengali. So I also face a lot of challenges now. Also, sometimes due to lack of practice, I'm not able to talk properly. I forgot the flow while speaking due to lack of practice.
Yeah. You know, I'm also like, I can also speak Bengali a little bit.
Yeah, you commented that little bit Bengali, you know. So what are the things you know in Bengali?
Speaking Bengali, I cannot write.
Okay. Some common sentences, you know, or normally you can talk in Bengali?
I guess normally, like, apni kemon achen.
You can tell me Tumi, no problem.
Okay.
Tumi kothay thako, and this kind of thing. Yes. Okay, alright Arundhati, it was lovely to talk to you. You are a very nice girl and also your English is quite good. Keep it up and all the best. Bye.
Okay, bye.